wedding today. You're welcome to Blood Mass Day 7. I'm Joket Soluwadisetu, and I have my friend here with me.
This is Dax, actually the most handsome gay people, Africanicious, supernicious, peppering husband.
So what are we going to be discussing today? We're discussing no other thing than this trending matter, which is called bullying. Bullying in schools, bullying at workplace, and...
When it comes to bullying can be everywhere. It starts from the home, to the schools, to the community, to the neighborhood, even down to workplace. You'll be surprised. And I have a load of experiences when it comes to bullying, and I'll be spilling them out one after the other.
This touchy one was the most recent thing that happened right here in Nigeria, West Africa, the globe, where a junior high student was bullied to death. It was a really pathetic story because he refused joining.
It's so painful to find out that until they take it to court to accentuate the fact that that was really what happened. But based on evidences that have been shared on social media, the young boy at the age of 12 was bullied to death. He was being coerced. He was being forced to join a cult group in a private school. That's what is so surprising to me, because a lot of people feel that not allowing your children in this part of the world, especially in Nigeria, West Africa, that not allowing your children to go to public school will save them from the menace of cultism. But I'm sure that in a well-organized institution like a private secondary school, which costs loads of millions of naira to have your children sent there, they are now having the same challenge. And this boy was forced to drink a chemical substance that actually led to his death, according to what our report the parents were filing out.
It's so pathetic. The situation is right so degenerated now that even in private schools, big private schools, I have this case of my daughter just some weeks back telling me, because I train my children to know how to earn money, not how to spend money. I don't even expose them to the currency in my country, because I've observed it over the years that when children are used to money, they know how to spend, they know this dollar, they know this naira amount. All their mentality will be on how to spend money. They don't know how to make money, and in the end, they end up bullying, they end up doing whatever they want to do to get it.
What we normally do is to ensure that everything they need, every normal thing, not just everything, every normal thing that they need, we use our hand to buy it for them. Not giving them money. We don't give them money to take to school, no. But whatever they need to use money to do in school, we put it in their bags, in their lunch bags.
Yes.
So that they are not used to money. But what we discover is that nowadays, children are used to a lot of obnoxious freedom.
Yeah.
You give a baby, a child that cannot work for 500 naira in her lifetime. You give that child 2,000 naira, 5,000 naira to school to do what?
Okay, that's the case of what actually happened. So my daughter came back complaining that there was this girl in the school, she used to plot money about and she used to say she goes here and there. So there was this day she went to the shop to get something, maybe I just gave them 150 naira that day because they don't know how to collect. I don't give them one for example. I think that was the first time or second time I did that. So the girl now went there. The girl was not like, it's like somebody is broke. She was just trying to intimidate my daughter that, hey, it's like, because what she wanted to buy, they said, it's not that amount. What the amount I gave her was small. I never wanted to give her. So they said, it's like somebody is so broke. Like my daughter now said, I'm not broke, you are the one that is broke. She was just trying to intimidate the girl. So today, I do.
And our daughter that is small. Baby, I call her a baby. Our daughter, that this small girl is saying that somebody is broke and this thing. This our daughter can, she's the one, she can prepare food for the whole family. She makes crafts that even we export to other countries.
And they give her money.
And they pay her in foreign currency for that. You understand? As in, she makes crafts, she, you know, this paper works and the like. She meets them and asks us to help her deliver it to motherless children or children that are suffering.
And at age 10, she can make jollof rice, fried rice, all the swallows we have in Africa. And not like so, she can even do the outros and everything. Right there, the way you are bringing children up now is, I think this is just the cause of this bullying. Because a child is not well trained, doesn't have manners, they have out,
you don't even understand. They're at home, the child is just to watch TV, that is housemaid. The housemaid is the one. Families are actually training more of housemaid, house help, than their own children now. House help will wake up early, we fry the plantain, we put the food in the lunch box, we even wear the children's socks. We even, the only thing they are not doing is to pick the food and be giving them into their giving it into their mouth at 8
They might be watching them do that. Because my brother big no, I think that's just the cause of all this that we're saying. So the children are really spoiled. They think they just have freedom of everything. So they want to go out there and just say, who are you? This
and is not that they see their mom and their dad fight themselves. They see the dad punching the mom and they feel, oh, for you to be in charge, for you to have authority, you need to, you know, extend some blows.
I saw this interesting video placed on the group chat of my children's school. You have to watch it. A white man, the daughter boomed.
No. Let's just show them the video.
Okay.
Good morning and happy Monday, everyone. Well, it's a happy Monday for some of us. A little background into this video that's being shot this morning. This lovely lady is my 10-year-old daughter, who has, for the second time this school year, been kicked off the school bus due to bullying another student. Let me make this extremely clear. Bullying is unacceptable, especially in my household. Friday, when my daughter brought home her paperwork for her bus suspension, she said, "Daddy, you're gonna have to take me to school next week." As you see this morning, she is learning otherwise. A lot of children today feel that the things their parents do for them is a right and not a privilege, such as parents taking their children to school in the morning, or even bus rides to school in the morning. All of that is a privilege and should be treated as such. So today, my beautiful daughter is going to walk 5 miles to school in 36 degree weather. I know a lot of you parents are not going to agree with this, but that is all right, because I'm doing what I feel is right to teach my daughter a lesson and to stop her from bullying.
So having watched this, I would like you to comment in the comment section below, just like the dad asked. The action you took, what? Because that girl now, she wants to develop the habit of bullying others in the school bus. They have to stop her, suspend her. So the fact that your children can go on the school bus, some things are privileges, they are not rights. The dad made sure he walked her. He was driving behind her. And dad said, "Dad, you're going to take me to school tomorrow." Which school? "You're going to track down." Then you stop. So some persons were saying, "This is wicked. It's too much." Some person said, "It's okay." I said, "That's great, because that's what I do." So yeah. I don't know. I want to know about you. Just comment in the comment section.
You remember the last time I said, our children are not good. I'm not going to be going to always drop them with the car again. That they should be walking down to school. That was when I knew that some things are just privileges that we should not allow to ruin our children. I was watching my girls. They never knew I was coming from the back. They never knew I was coming from the back. They don't know how to walk straight. They don't know how to walk straight. They were just walking like this. They walk like chickens. That they're looking for. I watched them closely. I was monitoring them from the back. But I tell you now, after a while, they've adjusted, they've improved. Before, if you are not taking them with the car to anywhere, they say, "Oh, my leg is paining." How can your leg be paining you at age what? So, it's part of the the summary of this discussion is the fact that bullying starts from the home. Bullying starts from the home. What the children see their parents do, what they watch on the TV, on the phone, on the internet, and all this. It's so pathetic that this boy that we are talking about here lost his life because he was bullied to death by the people that are supposed to be his classmates. And what are the things that they usually grab? Anybody that is bullying, any child that is a bully, they bully on the fact that they look down on others that they are below them, either because their parents are richer than those other ones, or not even that, they might not even know that their parents, not that their parents are richer, but their parents are poorly trained and they are poorly training them. Because rich people, real rich people, do not spoil their kids because they want those kids to come and take over their empire. So they allow them to go through processes. I can name an example. For example, in Nigeria, the owner of FCMB, that was the first bank I worked in, Balogun, he trained his children in such a way that you never know that they are from a billionaire's family. Ladi Balogun, the son of this rich man, took over FCMB, and it was fantastic. The change was a dramatic change. So, aside that, growing up, my own experience, let me just share my own experience. Growing up, I attended public school, and while I was in the public school, there is this young boy, those that attended the Lagos Mainland Local Government School. if they come across this video, they know what I'm talking about. There was this boy. He's so different. His hair is orange. He has this eyebrow. Everywhere is orange. So he looks strange and he's very wicked. And he bullies everybody. But there was a time that, and I'm this kind of person, I'm very meticulous, but don't overstress me. If I come back, it will not be good. So I was very calm. We were playing soccer, we were playing football during break. And this boy just came, collected the ball and said, for him not to be in that, to be playing, everybody's not going to play. I was like, everybody was shaking. I was talking about primary school. But because of the way I was trained that you just be good, but if anybody wants to ride on you, show them the other side. And my surname is a very funny surname, Akilapa. It means that somebody that has tough hand. So the boy's name was, they used to call him Lobuneko. Very funny.
What does it mean of Lobuneko?
Lobuneko means pursue war from Lagos. So when I saw that, I just came up. I said, no, you cannot scatter this game. You cannot do this. You will wait for your set because you're supposed to wait for your set. Everybody was shocked. I just saw that all my friends, they left me. I was the only one.
Fight alone.
And this boy was like, so you want to face me in this old school? How the fight started. I never knew where the energy came from because I knew that if I allow that boy to bully me, he will continue to bully me all my life. What I did was, I set my goal. I never knew how to fight boxing. So the boy was coming, he's a very good puncher. As he was throwing the punches, I was just dodging, first punch, I just bent down, picked it like that, slamming to the floor. And the rule of the game is that anybody that puts you to the floor, that puts your back to the floor, and puts sand in your mouth, that person's the winner. That was how I put the boy to the floor to hit him through. I said, I will punch you, but my mind was not that. I just carried the sand and put it to the floor. All my friends that ran away, they came back, they carried me, they separated the body, they said, yeah, I'm the ruler of the school now. You know what? Despite the fact that I was the acclaimed ruler, but I know that if they had let that boy, he would have finished me. But that day, I conquered like a young lady, and I saved the whole school the trouble. So anytime the boy is fermenting trouble anyway, they will say, we'll go and call Akilapa. They say, they will go and call me. That they will go and call for him and the boy will be angry. That how can I take over the meeting? But you know what? I am not a bully. I wasn't created that way. I was just so quiet till we finished that school. That was how I was able to deliver myself and deliver my fellow classmates. So most of the time you discover they are in school. And also, when I got another experience was, some of these experiences are good, you know. When I got into a particular organization to work for them, I had a boss that was a bully. He bullied me to the point that he now mentioned something on integrity against me. Wow. And I don't joke with my integrity. Immediately I heard that, my mind, something just crossed my mind that it's either I jump with this man from the skyscraper because it was a tall building, down to the floor, but for him to live here, and these people, I might not be able to gather them back to tell them that he was saying a lie. I stood up and said, excuse me, sir, you cannot do that. You cannot stain my integrity because I don't know where all these people that are going to, and they never have a second chance to hear my own part of the story. I refused to allow that. I confronted him. He was shocked because they always see me as, oh, very gentle boy. They can talk rubbish, they can say some nonsense. No, when it comes to character defamation, I don't joke with that. I confronted him. He said, I should get out of the office. I said, you are the one that will get out of this office. He said, what? I never knew all the senior managers in that company. They were so tired and fed up of the man that is a bully. That's how it does. They were so surprised that I was just in my entry level into that organization. I confronted him and he was a manager. I think either a manager or a senior manager. I confronted him. I was like, if I'm going to lose the job, let me lose the job. But not my character. Can't defame me. That was how I rescued myself. The man said, you know what? He's going to see me. He's going to meet me somewhere in the future. And he's going to deal with me. I said, no, on the contrary, you are going to meet me somewhere in the future, but I will be at the top. But you know what? I will not show you this kind of character. I will show you kindness. The man was like, he was just dumbfounded. Do you know that he actually could not do anything? He was very rich. He stood up, he left the office for me. And when I came out, all the other managers were like, don't disturb yourself with him. I was thinking that they would follow him and they said, that's how he does. Yeah. Oh, very good. You deflated his ego. That was how I deflated his ego. And before you knew it, the man resigned, went to another bank. I will mention the bank because the bank is no more now. He went to another bank called Oceanic. And that was when Oceanic Bank had their crisis and they laid off so many staff and the likes of them. But as God will have it, as faith will have it, I went to another bank and I was given the post of, I was employed into the recruitment section, HR. You know what? I told the people in the HR, I said, I'm waiting for that man. I described him, I said, I'm waiting for this man. He will come looking for a job. And you are going to do the paperwork, we are going to employ him. But you know what? Till I retired from the bank at age 35, I never saw him. But I still believe I will meet him somewhere and I'll be approved. He will need my help and I'll still write that. And I'll be able to talk sense into his life. Why am I sharing this? Don't ever be a bully. Because those that you think are below you, they might actually be the people to help you. And let me say this, in that same organization, I was able to bring some of the good managers to another organization at like 2 steps or 3 steps higher. So that is just how life is. Bullying doesn't pay. If you're a kid there and you are into bullying, you are only destroying yourself.
And parents that are adopting this modern, I met some guys, they were just trying to say they're not going to marry nowadays because all the children around are indomitable
children.
They do not do anything.
Yeah.
All they do is they just watch the TV.
They don't know how to cook.
They even tell my children face to face and say, we have bounce job. We do this, we do that. I said, okay, they are doing themselves. Wait for them in the next 10 years, you're going to see them. And these guys will tell me that, see, all these indomitable children, once they marry now, they come with house girl, they brought another wife, a second wife, and they can't marry their man. Parents, we should just try to at least let these children have the sense of life. Let them know what life is all about. It's not that you're bad. Teach them the things. Not at age 13, when you start it, it's not possible. It's not possible.
At age 9, I've already started cooking for family setup. At age 9. At age 9 and 10, I single-handedly prepared the food for a Christmas end of the year party for my school at age 10. So I'm so happy that I've been able to replicate the same in my children. I don't believe that a boy or a girl, whether you're a boy or a girl, you must know how to cook in my own house. Because I, as a guy, I learned how to cook, and that's why my wife cannot be shut down for me. So what are we trying to say? Bullying. No. Yes. Bullying, even you can even be bullying by what was it called? On the basis of gender. You can be bullying even your children. You make the girls to be the one to
be the assassin,
and the boys will be sitting on the couch watching TV. You are already introducing bullying as a system of communication of power, of authority into the young boy. And when he gets out, he sees female as substandard particles. You don't try that with my girls. Because I'm going to train them out to defend themselves.
That was what I told my daughter this morning. I said, if that girl should ever come across you again and say, then, I said, you said, you dare not in your life touch me or tell me such things.
The girl that is saying all this is rubbish. The school, they wanted to do, what was it called? They wanted to do end of the year decorations. They didn't look for the girl that they were handing, that the parents were giving 2,000 naira or what have you. They came to my girl to come and assist them in the decorations. That is, you are making value to come into your kids.
Value addition, what value are your children adding to society? Or do they want to become social miscreants? Do they want to add to? Because if you don't train the children to know, it's, let me tell you, education now, it's not just about all these divided years we learned in school. That's all we learned, where I taught economics. It's not about that. It's about what you're able to make out of when there is no job. There are no jobs anywhere. You create the job. You make the things happen yourself. So what are we saying? Today is just a very...
it's a very interesting one, and it's based on personal experiences.
Yes.
I want to share the last one. Let me share the last one. Our baby. Do you know our baby was bullied?
Victoria, yes.
Our baby that...
She was bullied at school. Now they did a lot of things to her. And just in their kindergarten classroom, they punctured her face, everything. And that girl was actually crying that she never wanted to go to school.
So please,
let's not train our children this way. It all starts from the home. Let's not train them. Most of the time, my children will feel I'm bad. I'm training them so hard. I would say, see, I never had this type of training. The way I was trained, I was pampered because I was the last in the family. I never knew how to do anything. So when I got married, the reality dawned on me.
And let me come in there. She was. She was over pampered. She doesn't know how to cook. She will be crying in the kitchen. I was like, oh, you've not started. And me at 8-9, I learned how to cook. What you are saying now is the improved version. I have worked on that. Now I can cook every kind of delicacies that you can ever think of. So that I will tell you more about it. In case you want to know more about that story, tell me so that we will do the video.
So when I was on pampered, I would think they were doing me good. I'll be happy. But when I got married, the reality dawned on me. I now started training myself, real training. So I promised that my children, I'm not going to raise them that way. So now when I'm training my children, they'll feel I'm mad. I'll say, 10 years to come, you are 10 now. 10 years to come, you'll come back and say, Mommy, thank you, God bless you. Thank you for training me this way. And please, let's make our children, let's make them great, and let them make our society proud once again. Please, don't let yourself.
So that we come to the end of today's vlog, because if I leave my wife, she will continue on this, because it's something that happens at Kukumba, at hearts, at heart. You understand what I'm talking about? So with that, we are going to say, take good care of yourself, make sure your family is safe, well, and...
And don't forget the food bank we are creating this festive season to feed at least 500 families with live chicken and foodstuffs. So you can reach out to us on the numbers showing below for whatever you want to give. You can just share the video to help save a life, and we'll give you updates on that so very soon. Thank you. Don't forget to join therapy. Catch you till we come your way. Next time in the next video, catch you. Love you. Bye bye. Julie, like to watch this video or this. Not only green, but summer's here, but also winter's
unchanging.